of the candidates you've seen so far, maybe we'll start with Offaly. Pat Flanagan and Peter Brady, the two big internal candidates. Do you reckon they'd be right for the Offaly job?
To be honest, for me, a personal idea of say Pat Flanagan going for a job, I don't think it's the right time for Pat Flanagan to take the Offaly job. To be honest, from my perspective, I just think that the players just at the moment, for the type of calibre that Pat Flanagan is as a manager, I just don't think the players are there. And I don't think for most managers the players are there at the minute. I think what Offaly really need to do is focus on the underage structure, build, and then get a real high profile manager in maybe 4 or 5 years' time. But they really need to build on what's there at the minute.
In many ways though, if they were to get Pat Flanagan in, if they were to snag him, he's a guy who knows these divisions, Division 4, Division 3, he got Westmeath from 3 up to 1, it'd be a big coup if they could get him in a way.
Oh yeah, definitely, you know, as I say, he brings a wealth of experience, both from club and his experience with both Westmeath and Sligo now. You know, having Westmeath promoted from Division 3 up into Division 1 in the space of 3.5 years was absolutely fantastic. He is a top quality manager, but have they got the players there at the minute? Westmeath were lucky, you know, Pat had a good idea of a lot of these young lads that came through, you know. The problem is, are the players there in Offaly at the minute? They're really, really struggling. You know, looking at the club football over the last couple of weeks, it's at a low ebb at the minute, Will.
Mm. Well, Peter Brady, heavily linked as well. He's a guy who the guys in Eton Derry seem to run through walls for. They reckon he's got a very professional setup and he's got a good backroom team there too.
Yeah, definitely. You know, Peter Brady has earned his crust, you know, to be in with a shout for this. You know, taking Eton Derry to a senior championship 2 years ago, you know, they're going real well. And a player, also a man who's been there 97 and that, he's got vast experience, he's a huge player, you know, another player that players will look up to, maybe he could get the best out of what's there at the minute.
Curveball suggestion is Dermot Early, who has been linked. It will be his first big management gig if he got it. I wonder if that's the right way for Offaly to go, though, to try and go with a guy who's just out of the game.
No, I don't think so. Look, again, I really think that these players that come straight out of playing need to start off a club, need to gain experience. It's massive step up to go in and train an inter-county team, never let alone a senior club team. So he needs to get that experience. Plus, you're going to have to ask the question, how much money is Dermot Early going to be looking for to take on such a job? And that's the thing that the Offaly County Board need to look at as well.
A concern some supporters have about Glenn Ryan will be similar, that you know, he's gone to counties before and there's been talk of big budgets and so on. Obviously, he's a guy who has experience, though.
Yeah, you know, he done really, really well with Longford. You know, again, he took them from Division 4 to Division 3 in the space of a couple of years, done really, really well with them. But again, it's going to come down to budget. How much is he going to cost the county board? You know, for me, they're nearly better off to start developing, putting money into players, getting the structures up within the county and put the money into it that way rather than going for a big high-profile name at the minute.
Before I go on to the Westmeath candidates, amazing that it took awfully so long to get a selection committee in place. I know there were guys who were kind of personally criticised last time round when they got involved, but to wait nearly 3 months to actually get your selection committee in place is a long time.
Yeah, definitely, you know, and I agree with that, and it was something that we actually spoke about amongst ourselves in Cusick Park yesterday. It's the same situation within Westmeath. You know, I know that they're starting, but the problem is, right, when the inter-county manager stepped down, automatically there should be a group set up ready to start looking straight away. Like, you're looking at quarter-finals, semi-finals and finals of championship coming up, and no managers in place in either Westmeath or Offaly to be looking at these players, and then you're expecting the manager to progress and start training maybe in November. It's just not a good set up, to be honest, you know. So it's difficult for the county board if they don't have a group set up to start proceeding straight away.
Because the worrying thing would be, whether you're Westmeath, whether you're Offaly, the senior championships, probably a lot of the external managers would know the guys who are playing for senior clubs, but wouldn't necessarily get a look at guys who are at the intermediate and junior level.
Yeah, and that's a massive problem. You know, like, if you go back to what, to say, the golden years of Westmeath in 2000 and 2004 and so on like that, you had Michael Ennis, who was a top quality player from junior clubs. Like, I think that you have to source the county from top to bottom to get the best out of these players and to get the best players in it. You know, you just can't be focusing on your senior football championship.
Very interesting as well. Niall Crew is in for both jobs, apparently, both Westmeath and Offaly. He's just out of Waterford as well. What kind of appointment would he be if either of them were to take him on?
It's a difficult one to know. He done reasonably okay with Waterford, but, you know, the consensus down in Waterford that he wasn't overly liked by the players, you know, even though he done reasonably well. So, you know, it could be a tricky one for both counties, but he's young, he's enthusiastic. Again, maybe that's what either county would need at this stage.
Interesting with Westmeath, the front runner seems to be Banty at this stage, who would have worked, of course, across the border from Westmeath before. He's potentially a big name appointment.
Yeah, definitely. You know, he was involved with the Monaghan Ladies in that last year. You know, he seemed to do reasonably well there. Then he had a poor time with Meath. You know, but when you look at his progress, what he done with Monaghan, he set the foundations for where Monaghan football is at the minute. You know, again, he could be a good appointment, but the question is, how much of a head of the ball is he, you know, with that? And that's the thing that they're going to have to look at too, like what sort of hype is he going to bring to the sidelines and things like that. So that would be a tricky one, but if he was to concentrate on the football, it could be a good appointment.
big appointment to make as well, because you know Westmeath drop back into Division 2, but a very competitive Division 2. As we've seen before, you can have upward progress very quickly, but Westmeath could well slide into Division 3 if they have a bad year.
Yeah, definitely, you know, and I think this is the biggest problem that people were looking at last year. You know, they had made the progress with Pat Flanagan up into Division 1. Paul Beelan stepped in, didn't know the players, an extremely poor year. Confidence is very low within the panel and that at the minute. Very easy to slide down. Like we look at Longford, they went from Division 2 straight into Division 4 in the space of 2 years, you know, with a change of management and all that. It could be, you know, they have to get the appointment right, make sure it's the right manager that to get in, because the main thing for Westmeath is that they have to be stable in Division 2 going into 2016. If they slide into Division 3, it could be a long time before you see Westmeath at top flight football again.
I wonder as well whether very set targets will have to be put out, because the feeling with Beelan was he felt he had 3 years no matter what happened, even if they lost every single game. Surely it'll have to be a performance indicators put in there for whoever comes in.
Oh yeah, definitely. I think, you know, when you have a manager that comes in that doesn't have a huge track record like what Paul Beelan had, he should be looked at from year to year. You know, giving a manager 2 or 3 years and then getting rid of him after a year isn't going to work. You know, like say if we look at the scenario at the minute where Westmeath football is, what they really looked at was, let's bring Paul Beelan in for the year and then Tommy Carr was supposed to step in. Like that's what the consensus was, but Tommy Carr didn't progress with the minors. And nobody wants Tommy Carr now to step on as a senior manager. So they're afloat at the minute, and they don't know where they're really going to go on that.
Well, even Tommy Carr has left the minor setup now. This is lots of local guys who have been linked as well. The likes of Ned Moore, Finn Barregan, Ray Smith, Peter Leahy. It's a while since Westmeath have had a boss from inside.
Yeah, definitely. You know, and if you're looking at all of them, probably Ray Smith probably to be the best man for it. You know, he progressed with the Downs over the couple of years, won 2 or 3 senior football championships, you know, with the Downs. He'd probably be the best candidate out of all them guys there at the minute. But Peter Leahy, you know, he's done really well with the Westmeath ladies winning Dáil Éireann. He's done well with St. Malachy's last year winning the Intermediate Championship, sustaining their senior status this year. You know, again, there is good men within the county, but the thing is, have they the experience to step up to this level at this stage?